There are countless songs, books, and movies about it, and it's believed to be the most powerful force in the universe. But why do we fall in love? Well, firstly, the heart has very little to do with our emotions. The real magic starts in the brain, within the limbic system. Being in love often creates very intense feelings of euphoria and excitement, and a level of happiness that can be indescribable. It may not surprise you then, that when people have romantic feelings, the areas in the brain that are activated contain chemicals that are responsible for addiction, euphoria, and desire. And some of the main chemical players are dopamine, oxytocin, and serotonin. Dopamine is released by the hypothalamus, a structure largely responsible for control of your autonomic nervous system, which regulates bodily functions that you don't consciously control, like blood pressure and digestion. Dopamine causes you to feel good and helps to motivate you to pursue your love interest. The increase of dopamine is linked to a decrease of serotonin, which can affect appetite. Some studies have even shown that the levels of serotonin in a person that is newly in love is comparable to some patients that suffer from obsessive-compulsive disorder, which could be one of the reasons people are obsessed with those that they are in love with. Oxytocin and vasopressin are produced in the nucleus accumbens, and they strengthen the bond between two people. Cortisol is also increased, which leads to stress and anxiety, and explains why some people experience a racing heart and sweaty palms when they see someone they love. The brain of someone in love has a lower threshold in the pleasure centers in the limbic system, meaning it's very easy for you to feel good. Not only that, but there's also a decrease in pain sensitivity. This is why people in love are often very happy despite their surroundings and situations. Studies that have been done on prairie voles show some interesting results. Prairie voles often have monogamous relationships. However, if the release of oxytocin and vasopressin are blocked, then they become promiscuous. But if they are injected with these hormones, but prevented from mating, they still will continue to be faithful to their partners. There are many proposed explanations as to why we love. Babies, for example, are almost completely dependent on external help for a large amount of time. So love has been seen as a way to allow mutual parental support and protection of children. Another explanation is that promiscuity has an increased risk of sexually transmitted diseases, which can lead to devastating effects such as reduced fertility and damage to the fetus. So love evolved as a way to allow us to enjoy long-term relationships with a partner. But these are all theories, and the truth is, despite love existing throughout our history and in every culture and age, no one really knows why we love. We just know that it's awesome. So do you have any theories as to why we fall in love? Leave your answer in the comment section below, and I hope you have a great day.